It says in Revelation 10 and 7, but in the days of the voice of the seventh angel, when he shall begin to sound, the mystery of God should be finished, after he have declared to his servants the prophets. I want to say this again now. If you notice, it says in Revelation 10, the seventh verse, in the days of the voice of the seventh angel, when he begins to sound, the mystery of God should be finished. And then right hurriedly, when we take a look over in Revelation 11:15, it said, and the last angel sounded. It says, and when the last angel sounds, the mystery of God shall be finished. And then immediately following in 11:15, it says, and the last angel sounded. So then when we check this out to see what took place when the angel sounded, in the John emphatically stated that when he sounded, it would be the end. When we check this out, we find that it's just exactly the way that John said it would be. John said, when he sounds, it will bring forth the end of the world. And we find in Revelation 11:15, when he sounded, it did just exactly that. When he sounded, it did just exactly that. For the Bible says, and the seventh angel sounded, and there were great voices in heaven, saying, the kingdoms of this world are become the kingdoms of our Lord and of his Christ, and he shall reign forever and forever. It is obvious that when this angel sounded, it did bring the end of the world. So we see that even way back, 96 A.D., when John was exiled to the Isle of Patmos, that here when he received this great revelation, that at the time that he received this great revelation, that even then, God gave him an inclination of what was to transpire in the end of the world. And that this thing that was to happen was to be right at the end time. That this angel would sound, and when this angel sounded, it would be the end of the world. So then in 11:15, the angel sounded, and when he sounded, it is stated that the kingdoms of this world became the kingdoms of our God. Now, first of all, you can notice this, that the Bible says that Satan, Lucifer, shall wear out the saints of God. He shall literally wear them out with all kinds of dogma, churchism, programs, with all kinds of pressures and harassment in purchasing and government and all of these things that you have to fill out to get a tag and license and everything else. He'll pressure the people to death, and the saints shall literally be beat down and wore out. But all of a sudden, there's going to come an inspiration. There's going to come a renewing. There's going to come a stirring. And all of a sudden, something is going to take hold of the saints of God that has never had a hold of the saints of God before. And the Bible says that they're going to rise and take the kingdom. There's going to be a new strength. There's going to be a new inspiration. God is going to do something that he's not done before. And all of a sudden, they're going to rise up and they're going to take the kingdom. And the Bible said they're going to possess it forever and forever. Hallelujah. And we begin to understand what the Bible is telling us when it speaks of Satan or Lucifer being a prince, a great ruler, a great power over the powers of the air. He is the ruler over the powers that are in the air. The atomic particles that are in the air, Lucifer is the prince of those atomic particles. He rules over the powers of the air. That means that he can start an earthquake.
He can start a cyclone. He has the power to start a cyclone or to stop a cyclone. He has the power to cause the ocean to boil like a pot. He has the power to interfere with your spirit on the inside, inasmuch as your atomic particles, that is your makeup, your human physics, are relative to this world. In that your human being is relative to this world, then that means that Lucifer, who is in this world and being the prince over the powers that's in the air, he can work through your intellectual reasoning. He can work through your five human senses. He can work through the atomic matter or the particles that your body is composed of. He creates an interference. He can cause sickness by creating complication in your physical being. He can war against your soul that's on the inside, your life that's on the inside. He can war against that by suppressing or oppressing your outer being. Satan is the power that rules in this world. He is the power that's in full control in this world. There is but one power that is greater. There is but one power that is supreme to Satan or Lucifer, and that is the powers of God Almighty. And so then Lucifer is the prince of the powers of the air. I say this over and over that it might find a lodging place in your mind and that you might fully comprehend what I'm trying to say, so that you'll understand when I begin to interpret what I'm saying. So then, ruler of this world, Satan is the prince of this world. Satan is the prince of the powers that is in the air. He has control of the atomic matter. That's why we have atomic warfare. That's why atomic warfare at this age and at this moment is beginning to billow like the tide of the ocean, because Lucifer is stirring the pot of the intellectuals throughout the world, and he's using the thing that's called fear to cause them to press on. He's causing all nations to be afraid. He's stirring all nations up. He's causing one man to be afraid of another man, one person to be afraid of another person, one nation to be afraid of another nation. Jesus constantly warned the people as he preached the gospel in this world. He said, "Fear not." Fear. Fear is the worst thing. Fear anything but God, and the fear of God is the beginning of wisdom. In the Old Testament, there was watchmen that were set upon the wall, and their job was to cry. If anybody came near those walls, they were to cry out. They were to cry. If anybody came near the walls, they were to cry out to arouse the people, to let them know that the enemy was near the wall. And today God still has watchmen on the wall. Those watchmen are not asleep. They are watching day and night. They do not sleep. God has them there for one purpose, that at that midnight hour they may give that midnight cry. But so far as the church world is concerned, the Bible said they all was asleep at the midnight hour. Did you know that today you cannot tell the church from the world? You can't tell the church from the world today. There was a time in life when you could distinguish between the church and between the world. There was a difference between God's people and the people of the world. All you had to do was just look at them and you could tell the difference. But brother and sister, today you can't tell the difference between the church and between the world. The church dresses like the world. The church acts like the world. The church goes to the places that the world goes to, and they all act just alike. Why? Because they're all asleep. Men sleep in the darkness. Jesus says here in the Word of God, he said, "Walk while you have the light." While there is light, he said, walk. He told him here, he said, "You disciples, keep on walking in the light. Keep keep on walking in the light. While you've got light, walk in that light, he said. For the time shall come when the light shall be taken away. And everybody will go into darkness. Everything will go into darkness. And so then at that midnight cry, the Bible said all of the virgins was asleep. All of them slept, and then at midnight there came a cry. All of them was asleep. Men sleep in the darkness. Did you know the Bible teaches that the carnal mind is darkness, and to be carnally minded is death? When you're absent of the mind of Christ, did you know that you are in darkness? And when you are in darkness, did you know that you are drunken off of the cares of this life? And that when you are drunken off of the cares of this life, that you are hard and fast asleep? Now the Bible said at the midnight cry, all of them was asleep. All of a sudden there came a cry at the midnight. All of them were hard and fast asleep. You know, God said, Paul, turn my people from darkness unto light. What God is trying to do tonight is to get us away from that carnal reasoning. You know, to be carnally minded is death. You know why being carnally minded is death? Because being carnally minded is worldly minded. Are you listening? Somebody would say, Brother Pike, what is the carnal mind? That horrible thing. I don't want any part of it. Being carnally minded is worldly minded. That's what the carnal mind is being worldly minded. You say, are you talking about automobiles? I'm talking about automobiles. Are you talking about homes? I'm talking about homes. Are you talking about land? I'm talking about land. Are you talking about money? I'm talking about money. I'm talking about being carnally minded, being worldly minded. If you are worldly minded, you are carnally minded. If you are carnally minded, then my brother and sister, you are walking in death and you will perish because you are asleep and you are not awake in the things of God. Somebody would say, Brother Pike, you mean to tell me that I can't think on automobiles and go to heaven? I mean to tell you, you can't think on automobiles and go to heaven. Somebody would say, you mean to tell me I can't think on land and houses and go to heaven? I mean to tell you, you can't think on land and houses and go to heaven. You say, Brother Pike, you mean to tell me that I can't think concerning the things out here in the world and go to heaven? I mean to tell you that you can't think concerning the things of the world and go to heaven. You mean to tell me, preacher, that I can't have an automobile? I didn't say you couldn't have an automobile. You mean to tell me that I can't have a home? I didn't say you couldn't have a home. The Bible didn't say anybody would go to hell for having an automobile. The Bible doesn't teach that anybody will go to hell because they have a home. The Bible doesn't say that anybody will go to hell because they've got a piece of ground. It doesn't say that they'll go to hell because they work and make a living and they have to handle the things of the world to do it. But brother, the Bible teaches that if any man gets worldly minded, that man will die and go to hell. You can have all the carnal things that you want. And Paul said, if I've sown unto you spiritual, shall I not be partakers of your carnal? Shall I not reap of your carnal things? You can have all that you want. As a matter of fact, if you'll seek the kingdom of God, the Bible said all of these things will be added unto you. But brother, the day that you get your mind on those things, you are on your way to hell. The very day that you get worldly minded, carnally minded, the very day that you get automobile minded, the day that you get your mind on the things and materialistic values of this world, you are on your way to the lake of fire. For to be carnally minded is death. You can have the things of this world, and God has given them to you, and God wants you to use them. And the Bible said the things of a wise man is precious in his sight. If God gives you houses and lands and cars and whatever, God expects you to take care of them. He expects you to be a wise steward over them. He expects you to honor God with them. But brother, he doesn't expect you to love them. He doesn't expect you to put your affection on them. He doesn't expect you to get your mind on them. I feel faith in this place tonight. I'm telling you the truth. I feel faith in this place tonight. I do. Glory to God. I feel the resurrection and the life here. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Let's love Jesus tonight. While they're playing on those instruments there, let's just lift our hearts and lives up to Jesus tonight. And let's tell him we love him tonight. The Bible said, I would that men everywhere lift up holy hands. Are your hands holy tonight, friend?
The Bible said God has perfected forever them that are sanctified. Them hands are holy tonight. Don't you let the devil tell you them hands ain't holy. Jesus made them hands holy. If thou canst believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, you can lift up holy hands tonight. Do you believe on the Son of God tonight? Do you believe on the Son of God tonight? Lift up them holy hands tonight if you believe on the Son of God. Hallelujah. If you believe on the Son of God, lift them hands up tonight. Oh, hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Can you say hallelujah? Can you say hallelujah? Can you say hallelujah? I said, can you say hallelujah? Glory to God. Hallelujah. Let's just love Him for a few minutes. Let's just praise Him for a few minutes. Hallelujah. While they're praising God tonight, if you're out there tonight and you need something from God, the altars are open again tonight. They were open last night. They're open again tonight. If you feel that Holy Spirit tonight, then brother, let God do something for you. If you're waking at that midnight cry and you feel that all on the inside, if you feel the moving of that great Spirit on the inside, then don't quench the Spirit. The Bible said don't quench the Spirit. If you feel the Spirit of God, be led by the Spirit of God. Hallelujah. Somebody said, now, Brother Pike, you don't have to get emotional. Jesus never got emotional. I'll tell you what, when Jesus planted the whip and Jesus turned over the tables and Jesus popped the whip and Jesus run him out of the money, out of the temple, he was excited. He was emotional. Jesus got emotional many times. Did you know that? Jesus got emotional because he had something to be emotional over. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And he cried with a loud voice. You know, the Bible said to lift up your voice like a trumpet. Did you know that's loud? The Bible not only says praise God, but it said praise him with a loud voice. Hallelujah. Cry loud unto the Lord. Hallelujah. Make a joyful noise unto the Lord. God is a spirit. He inhabits the praise of his people. And brother, when you praise God, the Holy Spirit comes down and something takes place. While they're praying tonight, I want you to step out and come to this altar tonight. There's folks that need to be in this altar tonight. Now, folks, I feel it tonight. I feel the Holy Ghost here tonight. And I can tell by the Spirit of God that there's people that need to be in this altar tonight. I want you to come to this altar tonight. You say, Brother Pike, what are you going to get out of the altar? Glory to God, you'll be on the altars. You'll be on the altars. You'll be on the altars. And when you get close to the altar, you get closer to God. How do you get closer to God by coming to the altar, Brother Pike? Because you begin to believe. You begin to believe. I know that all you've got to do is call upon the name of Jesus. But God works through faith. And we've been trained to come to the altar. And brother, we need to get back to coming to the altar. Because it inspires our faith. It inspires people. Hallelujah. When people came to the altar, they got something. When people prayed around the altar, they were filled with the Holy Ghost. And them kind of people lived the holy life.
This is Sister Betty Pike. Una de las Betty Pike. My mother and Brother George Pike's wife. La pasanari mama yangu na mimuku wa ndugu wetu George Pike. Please make her welcome. Na fadhali mpote ya kwamba amekaribishwa. Give her a clap of hands.
Hebu tumpigie makofi anapokuja.
Put your hands on top of your head and give her a good hand.
Mponapo juu ya kichwa na mpigie makofi anapoongea.
Another one.
Tena ingine.
Amina.
Kweli nimekwenda kwa salimu katika jina la Yesu Kristo. Mimi ni watu wa ajabu.
Basi kila wakati mwepo na sana kile kioni kisema kwamba Bwana ajua kwamba basi wa kuogimi kwangu. Unasema huko sehemu za Amerika. Basi kila wakati nikipata barua kutoka kwa watu wa Afrika. Sasa zingine mimi ucheka, sasa zingine mimi ulia. Unajua kwamba bila Yesu Kristo sisi sio kitu. Lakini tukiwa na Yesu sisi ni kitu, na sisi ni kila kitu.
I thought tonight, let's not
be
talking about
that place
day. I come to an end.
And
I just
had
love to bring all of our people in America, in our church, over here to fellowship with these people. I was talking to Brother Bernard this morning on the phone, and I was telling him, you know, nobody has to tell me about Brother Pike.
Unajua kwamba nilikuwa naongea na ndugu Bernard leo simuni, nikamwambia katika simu, nikamwambia kwamba hakuna mtu ambaye anaweza kunieleza kuhusu ndugu Pike.
I've lived with him over 40 years now.
Nimewahi kuishi naye sasa zaidi ya miaka 40.
And really, the only man that I've ever seen that stays on his knees every night of his life.
Lakini mtu ambaye sijawahi kuona mtu kama huyu ndugu ambaye kila wakati na kila usiku anakaa chini na kutia kati Mungu.
He's not playing a game.
Yeah, achesi mchezo.
He checked with him tonight, he wouldn't have a penny.
Na basi wewe mwenyewe ukimwangalia usiku leo huwezi pata pesa hata kidogo kwako.
If you'd checked with him 10 years ago, he wouldn't have a penny.
Hata miaka 10 iliyopita kama unaweza kumwangalia hauna na pesa yoyote katika mwili wako.
He never asked when the Lord speaks to him, you know, how much money we got.
Na basi wewe unisa vile Mungu anataongea naye ile pesa kiasi gani ambacho tuko nacho.
He always said the Lord wants me to go to a certain place.
Na kila wakati anasema kwamba Bwana anataka niende mahali hapa.
And the Lord always provides a way.
Na kila wakati Mungu huleta njia.
And tonight, you know, it's not the special person.
Na basi unajua kwamba usiku leo tuna jioni leo wewe ni mtu.
Every person here lives in their own little world.
Na basi kila mtu hapa anaishi katika ulimwengu yao ambaye ni kidogo.
You know, we think of the people as a crowd.
Na basi tunafikiria watu ambao ni umati.
But every person is special to God tonight.
Lakini kila mtu ni mtu ambaye ni maalum, tena mtu wa maana machoni pa Mwenyezi Mungu.
No matter how little or how big we are.
Haijalishi vile tuko wakubwa ama vile tuko wadogo.
He knows the thoughts and the intent of our heart.
Basi yeye ujina fikira na ajua pia moyo wetu.
You know tonight as he brings forth the word of God.
Unajua siku ya leo anapoleta neno la Mwenyezi Mungu.
How many of you know the word of God is you can stand on it.
Watu wangapi wanajua kwamba neno la Mungu unaweza kusimama juu ya neno la Mungu?
It's never failed one time.
Na basi neno la Mungu haikosi hata kamwe.
We put it to the test and through my life I've never had it to fail one time.
Kila wakati tumejaribu na katika maisha yangu sijawahi kuona kama neno la Mungu limepungukiwa kitu hata kamwe.
We have eight children.
Sisi tuna watoto nane.
And as they were growing up.
Na basi wanapokuwa wakikua.
There was times that we didn't know where our next meal was coming from.
Kuna wakati ambao hatukujua kwamba chakula yetu ya siku fulani itatoka wapi.
But you know tonight I can truthfully say that we never went lacking.
Lakini naweza kuambia kwamba usiku leo hata siku moja hatukukosa hata kamwe.
Things happen like one little incident. I remember that one of our children we stopped to get something to eat.
Basi vitu vifanyika vile rafiki siku moja tunasimama na watoto wetu tukisoma mahali ili tupate kitu kukula.
All we had was a little bit of money.
Na basi nilikuwa na pesa kidogo tu.
And I bought just some bread and something to make them a sandwich because we was in the car traveling.
Na basi nilikuwa na kanunua mkate na kitu kidogo ya kuwapatia kitu sawa nilikuwa katika gari tukisafiri.
One of the little boys wanted to know if we couldn't have a cantaloupe.
Na basi unao kijana mmoja alikuwa anataka kujua kama anaweza kuona kitu kingine kizuri ama fulani.
But you know, I said, no, not this time. But you know, God heard that. We got in the car and started down the highway. Brother Clark asked me, he was tired. He's been driving a long time. He said, would you not ask me if I would drive a little while? So I just pretty stopped the car, got out, and started running from the driver's side. And laying in the grass in front of the car was the prettiest cantaloupe I ever seen. I just picked it up and walked around and I said, here's your cantaloupe. You know, a child can do that. I learned with just a cantaloupe. In mighty years after learning faith, George said to me one day, I feel like we're supposed to go to Israel. And I thought, Lord, we don't have any money. And I said, okay, if that's what the Lord wants. You know, I made all the plans. We paid all the bills. I told George just a few days before we were supposed to leave. I said, we don't have any money. He said, God will make the road. Just about 2 days before we left to go to Israel, somebody made a mistake. They came over with it and wanted to try it on. I said, well, couldn't he wait in the morning? He's already in bed. They insisted that he tried on that night. But he said, well, and you know, when he put the coat on, he just automatically put his hands in the pocket. And there was a piece of paper in it. So you know we can supply the cantaloupe for the little girl. And we can supply the $10,000 for the ones that need it. You know, y'all pray for us because our only desire is to serve God. And the Bible says the beginning of wisdom is to fear God. So how many of you want to be wise tonight? And fear God. Keep his word in your heart. Don't fear Satan. Because he has more power over you. Love the Lord with all your heart.
She just told a little bit of some great wonderful things that's happened in our family. She mentioned one thing, Joe, what made me think about home. I have 3 brothers, and I have 4 sisters. And if they could, they would all be here right now. But they're all busy. One of my brothers is named Joe. I was thinking about him and Brother Joe interpreting. So God has given me a spiritual brother here, but I still miss my natural brother. And we travel all over the world together, and my whole family sings.
We pray to God, God always answers. We've been raised that way since we were little bitty children. The only thing we know to trust is the Spirit of God. I'll soon be 29 years old. My oldest sister is about 40 years old. My youngest sister and my youngest brother is about 19 years old. And none of us have ever found that God let us down. Every time we've ever asked Him, I can truly testify that He has answered. If you don't believe it, you should try it. Try to be honest with God. And you'll find out He's real. Now we're not going to take any more time. We appreciate the money that you give. And I know that the ministers appreciate it. We appreciate you attending the crusade night after night. Tonight, Dad will be ministering over the telephone to our church back in Georgia. It will only be the morning there, and they will all be in the sanctuary, waiting anxiously to hear Him speak to him about you people. To hear Him tell them about this crusade. So that they will know their money was spent for you. That the gospel might bring you together. That while we're worshiping God here tonight, they will be worshiping God over there this morning. So in their behalf, I bring you the love from the people in Georgia. And if you're not them, I want you to give them a hand clap so that I can take your love down to them. And I'm sure they will appreciate it. Now we're going to get one more hand clap. It's for the man of God. Here's what this crusade is all about. Because God has blessed him and raised him up among all of his fellow men. He has exalted him and given him millions of dollars.
Yes,
large airplanes, large boats, millions of people around the world. But wait day after day, I'm going to kill for this great prophet of God to come to them. And while you are privileged to hear Him tonight, there are as many people that would love to trade places with you. We're coming back to our Lord Kingdom. So a greater crusade. We want you to write us. We want you to stay in touch with us. We can inform you about plans for Kenya. We want to work with you. And we want to help you. During this many years praying for you people. And now God has enabled us to come here. Make Him welcome tonight. This is His last night here. But He'll continue to pray for you for many years to come. So enjoy this service
as a Friday.
And accept my love for you. I do love you. And I believe that you love us also. Praise God. Give Him a hand clap. My Father, I will have words
packed.
First of all, I'd like to say that I'm glad to be here tonight.
Kwanza ningependa kusema kwamba nafurahi kuwa hapa jioni tena jioni kama zamani nilikuwa hapa.
We keep making reference tonight when the sun is still shining.
Nafikiri wakati sisi kama jioni kama jua bado linawaka.
But we know that now is on its way.
Najua kwamba pia usiku ina.
Just as the sun is sinking behind the horizon.
Na vile jua inapokaa huko juu inapotoka.
So is the days of grace gone.
Na pia
siku za neema zimekwenda.
The blood is almost ready to come off of the seat of atonement.
Na basi hiyo damu iko karibu
kuifanyika. So let me encourage you this evening to give your hearts to God. This is the last night of the crusade.
Yeah,
if I say something to you, and you don't quite understand,
na uwezi kuelewa hiyo kitu vizuri,
if you don't agree,
kama uamini,
don't run away,
usikimbie.
A wise man will listen until everything is said.
Basi kila mtu mwenye hekima usikiza kila kitu ambacho usema.
The Bible said a fool, he'll judge something before he even hears it.
Biblia inasema kwa mpumbavu yeye atakata hukumu hata kabla hajasikia kitu.
A man that's not wise and a woman that's not wise will give their opinion on something before they know about it.
Mwanamke ama mume ambaye si ana hekima
an unwise person will only listen long enough to get something to go gossip for about.
Basi mtu ambaye asiyekima anasikiza kitu ila chukua hiyo kitu akafanya ushengenyano,
or something to argue about,
ama kitu kubishana naye,
just to cause division,
ili alete magawanyiko.
And the Bible says that God hates them that causes division.
Na Biblia inasema kwamba Mungu huchukia wale watu ambao huleta magawanyiko.
Anytime you see a man dividing the congregation, he is of the devil.
Ukiona kila mtu anagawa umati wa Mungu, jua kwamba huyo mtu ni mtu wa shetani.
When he causes division, it is of the devil.
Akijua kwamba
that's the one thing that God hates. Let me tell you tonight, there is but one God, there is but one faith, there is but one baptism. Folks, if there's only one God, if there's only one baptism, if there's only one faith, then let me ask you a question. If there is but one, the Bible says there's one God.
Do you believe
there's just one God?
The
Bible says there's one God. We're saved by faith in what the Word of God says.
Even
God sinners will speak God's Word.
And
faith cometh by the hearing of the Word. And we're saved by faith in the Word. But the Bible said in the last days many shall depart from the Word of God. It says they shall depart from the faith, giving heed to seducing spirits and doctrines of devils, having the conscience seared with a hot iron. Over in the States recently, they published a big article in the paper. Numbers of times we have the newspapers to cover our ministry. They come from colleges. They come from the big newspaper offices. The biggest papers in the nation of the world. The news meals on TV. They cover our meetings. I try to speak the truth because the people hear it. Sometimes we speak to tens of thousands of people by radio or TV. I try to program the people's mind with the truth. There is but one God. If that one God is the one the Bible speaks of, then where is the other God? The Bible said, I know not of any other God. When I stretched out the heavens, I did it alone. God said, I know not of another God. Where is there another God? He said. I know not of any. But there's but one God. And that's the Bible God.
There is
room for all of the other gods. Who is that one God? That one God is Jesus Christ. God, the eternal spirit, manifested himself as one God. There is another God. I challenge any God in the world. I challenge any God that says there's another God. I've been among the witch doctors. The devils and the demons. I challenge them. There is another God.
I will be for the gods and Goliath.
Oh, how many of you know him?
Well, I am men.
I am a humble.
Well, tells.
That's not a humble.
This God, Allah.
You mean the man who
Allah is man?
Allah.
You know Allah.
Allah is a man.
Allah is a man.
That's a lie.
You mean the uncle.
Where is man, Allah?
You know Allah.
Jesus is God.
No, see the movie.
I challenge Allah.
I put on
you. I challenge Allah by the style of.
And it's all over the world.
I've been in India. I've been among the Muslims.
I'm
challenge every denomination in the world.
I'm
challenge every religion in the world.
I'm
challenge every person that's religious in the world.
It's
the
Christ Jesus.
Yes,
it's
the Christ Jesus.
He killeth, God killeth, God maketh alive.
God
wounds. God heals. God binds up. The Bible says God has his will in all things. God makes all things after the counsel of his own will.
What
is that?
Because
there is no other God. The Bible says God has his way in the affairs of men. He rules in all things. I've heard lots of things about lots of gods.
But you know what happened? You need to send a question.
I've been there.
You know what happened?
I faced him with their death.
So you know what happened?
Face the death!
That's what we need for us.
I put him in the group of us.
I found alive.
Because if I come on here, God doesn't have any power.
I want to push.
When you face him with God doesn't have any power.
That's what I put him in the ground and do.
I challenge any man of the world to turn over the power of their God.
That's what I put him in the ground.
That thing never can.
I want to
put him in the ground. I've never met.
The best thing
the
Lord of the
day now. One God of power.
What I mean to the world?
God!
What I mean to the
world? He said!
Bless you, the very Holy Spirit!
Now get it going, Rocky!
Let's give God a hand, folks.
Everything to the
I'm singing this God Jesus. When we enter the great Holy Spirit, I'm seeing him deliver from devils. I'm seeing him heal people. I'm seeing him work miracles. I'm seeing him supply the needs of the poor. I've never seen another God in the
world.
No,
there is no other God.
Let's give him another hand.
We need to walk to a new worship.
Let's lift our hands up in love and
kindness. Oh, we're going to get into
the
place.
We're going to believe in God.
We must go out on
one God.
One faith.
One
faith.
One faith.
One
faith.
One faith.
One baptism.
What is the
name? One name of Jesus Christ.
One faith.
One faith.
One faith.
One faith.
One faith.
One faith. One faith. One faith.
One
faith.
One faith.
One faith.
One faith.
One faith.
One
faith.
One faith.
One faith.
One
faith.
One faith.
One faith.
One faith.
One faith.
One faith.
One faith.
One faith.
One faith.
One faith.
The name of the Lord is a strong tower. Hallelujah, hallelujah, his name, blessed children of God.
That's your life,
hallelujah, his name.
No,
the devils can't get to you. The devils can't harm you. The devils can't touch you.
We
should have your children of the living God.
That's
let's worship God.
That's acceptable.
Don't be afraid.
Be open.
The Bible
says
if you wait, please God, he makes it even thine enemies be at peace with you.
You must have a thumb up for that womb.
Don't move on to put him under
it. The devil is your enemy.
So if I never want
it, can't touch you.
Oh, it's Kukusa.
Death is your enemy.
Go look
at you now.
Thank you.
Kukusa.
David loved God. He passed from death to the life.
What am I going to put on my
death?
It's
not
in the
death.
Never
come into condemnation.
I want you to put everything to me.
Because your children are believing God.
So I need one of the nations.
Let's give him a hand.
Hallelujah. God bless your precious heart.
Right on,
I can really believe that.
And you know what I mean?
I bless you tonight.
Nobody can
I bless you tonight.
Nobody can
I have the power to
bless you tonight.
I
challenge any God to define my blessing tonight.
I bless you in the name of Jesus.
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 Thank you. Poverty and widows' tabs.
I must give
glory to God.
You will let me
tell you something.
I don't want to be a kid.
The devils can't stand in the presence of God.
Shatana swam us and
bring
peace to the gospel.
Oh, I'm not putting you.
You will have to leave.
Shatana,
glory to God.
Hallelujah.
I feel like dancing.
Hallelujah. 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 Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God.
Save the Lord.